refs here, again, from what
ladies
I've just seen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest will require you all to remain in your seats because this is a Halloween Wrath Street Fight!
Uh-oh, a Halloween Wrath Street Fight. You might even call it a Trick-or Street Fight. Oh, there you go, Pete Corvus.
He's back, your boy.
From Brooklyn, New York, weighing 235 pounds, repping and company, Pete Corvus.
The best part of Pete Corvus is his entrance music. But I will say, I've personally seen Pete Corvus fight and beat up many a person, and his opponent here likes to do that as well. This is a big return. Wait till you see who his opponent is. I don't know if you can see on my notes, but I know you know this guy very well.
Oh, I know him. Will Moore, meaningless trivia, I've been on the road with him for shows. At different parts of his career, at certain parts I couldn't stand to be in the same room with him.
I get that. I understand. Here we go. And wait for that music here.
Ooh,
oh, there we go.
We got Brooklyn versus Moonshine Creek, Kentucky.
Is that... Why did you just pull a flask out of your jacket? What do you have in there? You were hanging around with this guy before the show, weren't you?
His opponent,
don't you dare.
Moonshine Kentucky.
Oh, there
he goes. 185 pounds.
He's looking. I haven't seen him in a minute. He's looking lean and mean.
He really is. I haven't seen him in a long time. But if there's one thing I remember about this guy, and pardon my French, but he's a mean son of a...
You know what?
Yes, exactly. And then, you know, the crowd solidly behind him.
There was a time when there would be no handshaking with the crowd with this guy. Like I said, it's been ups and downs.
And I mean, if you're going to have a street fight, who better to have a street fight than the Roughneck Clay Sawyer? Oh, and here we go.
Like I'm saying, Brooklyn versus Moonshine Creek, Kentucky.
Brooklyn versus Kentucky. That's an interesting... St. Corvus can't take his time like this. He's, you know, he's being an idiot. He's got to stay. You got to stay on Clay Sawyer. Because if you don't, look what happens.
So far, it's just a wrestling match. But we know the street fight's going to break out any minute. But right now...
And I mean, you have to realize, I don't know if people watching this realize, Ref Jumbo is really just here as a formality to count a pin. He really doesn't have much power in this match. I think they could basically, you know, short of homicide, I think they could pretty much do what exactly they feel like doing here.
They can knock the ref out. Now you won't have a ref to do the count.
Well, there's other refs here. I mean, I'm sure they could figure something out.
Well, Ozzy left.
Oh, that's right.
He's probably in his car right now.
He probably is. He's probably on his way to wherever the hell Steve Lugo's going tonight.
Right, exactly. He's probably on the cell phone right now talking to Steve Lugo.
Maybe he's on the way to the bank to cash that check.
Yeah, exactly.
Seeing that's, you know, Clay Sawyer, like I said, hasn't been here in a while. Taking the time, getting to know Pete Corvus before he takes it to the streets, if you will.
Right. Now, off the road.
And, you know, the streets of Pompton Lakes are no joke. You know, I got lost on the way to the building. I had to stop and ask the cop for help, and he told me, you don't want to go to Pompton Lakes.
Really?
I don't know. It's a nice town. I like it.
That's what I said.
Stupid.
Okay. I guess that's kind of street.
It's a street fight, bro.
Yeah. All right, I think the street fight's about to start.
And you know, I will. I as much as I hate to put Pete Corvus over here, let's do it. I don't know if you're familiar, but Pete Corvus growing up in the Catholic, the Catholic school system, in New York, and you know, that's not easy for a pasty Catholic white boy. Very, very tough to grow up in a Catholic school system.
Yeah,
a lot of fighting. Yeah, and he's Irish. Those people fight. They wake up, drink beer, and fight. That's pretty much what they do.
Me.
But he's here, fighting.
And now they're going out. They're right in the entranceway.
They are. They're right in the they're in the lobby right now. Did you just see that lady grab her stuff and run?
Yeah.
But we got our head of security right out there, so nothing will get out of control.
Right by the ATM machine. I don't know what the significance of that is. But it was by the ATM
Well,
machine.
You know, sometimes you can't find an ATM. So why not have one at a street fight? What the hell, right?
Sure.
Oh, you see? And, Rich, I know what you're thinking. Oh, sure, you take the Irish guy near the bar. But you know what? You made the joke, not me. Shame on you.
You trying to put that on me?
I didn't do anything.
You're going to get canceled.
Oh, and the crowd loving this. I mean, who doesn't like to see a street fight? It's a I'm not sure what a Halloween's Wrath street fight is, but it sounds good.
I mean, I don't think any street fight has rules, right?
Well, good point. I don't think there's a such thing as rules on the street.
Could have been a couple extra pumpkins, or a couple.
Yeah, so maybe some Halloween decorations. Yeah. That would do. Okay.
I'm wearing this jacket with the skulls.
Oh, he's bringing them right over here.
Hi, guys.
Right over to the commentary table. And he's he offered him. See, now that's a nice thing. Those actually are very good, French fries from the concession stand here.
And Corvus is enjoying it. He's eating it.
He is. Well, I mean, you know, it's free. Who doesn't like free food?
Energy. It's energy.
Oh, go. What's he go? See? Oh, on the floor. What's he going? I don't know what he's going for, but he's not getting all of it. Oh, super. Ouch! He felt that one. What was that through? Was that through something, Rich? I can't see from my angle.
A door.
A door? Oh, my God. What the hell is a door doing outside the ring during a street fight? It's got to be the most ridiculous thing I've seen today.
Is this your first street fight ever, J-Wise?
Today? I haven't seen a street fight, at least since the last time I saw a street fight.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
That explains it all. Oh, yeah.
Another door. Hey, that looks like the door on my bedroom.
All right, now you've seen another one.
So what do you think? Do you think when the matchmakers are putting these matches together, do you think they go to Home Depot and say, like, hey, I'm looking for a door? And when they say, what do you need it for? They say, I want to put somebody through it. Like,
they would deny it, but I wouldn't put anything past anybody.
I mean, you would think we would be sponsored by, like, a Home Depot, Lowe's type of store. Well,
and there's ropes.
Right in the little, a low blow with the ropes.
You know what's funny? They're doing all that pulling out of the doors, but I think that hurt more than the doors ever could.
Come on, John, talk. You're so used to talking, talk.
He's talk. Look at how impressive Pete Corvus is there with his stupid-looking haircut.
Oh, boy.
I don't want him to come over here. I should probably talk about how great Pete Corvus is right now. He's impressive. He's winning.
Wait a minute.
I bet you he wants to do this to me. Well, that was impressive.
All right.
Actually, you know, now that you mention it, I probably should lay off of Pete Corvus because last time I talked about him too much, I went to my car and there was a Bad Company shirt laid across my windshield. So I'm kind of, I don't know what would happen next time. It might be then and not just a shirt. So I should probably you know, stop saying mean things like that about them. Unless, do you want to walk me to my car after the show?
Sure. You must think a lot of me to think that I could protect you.
I don't know.
You think these skulls on my jacket will scare him off?
Oh, here we go. That's like a... Basically, we're in a room connected to a bar, so it's basically a bar room brawl.
Okay.
Off the ropes. Oh, under.
Roughneck.
Oh, huge sidewalk slam. Huge sidewalk slam.
All right, I think he might be...
No. Oh, and it, you know, he didn't hook that leg. I mean, it's easy for us to say that. We're behind the microphone, but I mean...
The leg may be heavy to lift when you're taking all that punishment. You're tired.
Very, very good point. And you can't, you know, you can't say a match like this that one of them has an advantage because they've both been in numerous matches like this. What does he have?
We have an experience. The crowd already answered that before you did.
I didn't hear
him. What is this? They said, thumbtack.
Oh, God.
And I think they're right. I think we have an experienced crowd. I think we have a deathmatch crowd on our hands. Because they were right.
So I'm going to say the... As is shown in the past, typically the first person to be able to utilize those thumbtacks is the one that gets the victory. So we shall see. Oh, is he going from? He's going
this
for a monkey
flip. This can go very wrong. That's
I don't know if he's
for somebody. Oh.
Well, he tried, but he didn't get the monkey flip. But Pete Corvus catching him, tossing him into.
Well, Pete Corvus is.
If he goes for that package pile driver, that's it.
No!
Oof! I think there's some in his head. Well, I mean, very impressive.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Halloween Rap Street Fight, Pete Corvus.
See, and there's bad company. So. I'm not going to say anything about them.
I think Ray Sullivan needs an ambulance already. Why do we need them to inflict more damage?
It'll be interesting to hear what they have to say.
And your winner, he represents bad company, Pete Corvus.
Well,
I'm glad that you guys got a smile on your face. Because I'm about to turn that smile upside down. Because after that BS that management tried to pull on us, putting us against the Towers of Terror, biggest guys they could find to try and dethrone the longest reigning undefeated tag team champions in SWF history. No, it sure as hell ain't changing anytime soon. But because of that, we're going to take November off so SWF can go ahead and try and find us actual suitable opponents. And if you guys don't like it, y'all can kiss my...
His bail?
He did say to kiss his bail. I mean, hey.
No, we don't need another fine. We're going to have to pawn off these titles if that happens. Because, you know, we don't, clearly. No, you walked out. We won. Hey, they tell you to work smarter, not harder in wrestling, right? So, in order to work smarter, I think you guys, as you said, just take November off, collect your thoughts, go on vacation. Nice little, don't boo me. What is the matter with you people? Have you no... You guys get the weekends off from a 40-day, 40-hour week at work. I think my boys, the longest reigning tag champs in the company, deserve a month off. So, while you guys go on your little vacation to Aruba, Jamaica, exactly, Kokomo, you know, they want to go to Kokomo. I will stay around for November, and I will take care of business here, so when bad company returns, it's like nothing ever changed. You guys are still tag champs. I'll make sure you guys have suitable opponents, not two big lug nuts that have no brain cells. And who knows? Maybe I'll have a title when we get back.
I mean, he's not wrong.
As you guys know, we like to make messes and leave them for somebody else. So, yeah, you guys better find someone to clean that up because we're out of here.
All right. Music.
That's right.
You guys, we got a large dose of bad company today.
But if you're going to be looking at your phone, you better be staring at me, and I'm talking about you, you big old bastard over there in the back. Yeah, look at him looking on his phone. He has no idea I'm talking about him. Not even paying attention. Yeah, you! Yeah, you ugly mug! Yeah, you! Jesus!
Destiny.
The biggest goddamn names in Jersey, and you can't even pay 5 seconds of attention on us?
These kids are so scared of him, they got him covered up for Halloween. That's so bad, bro. Probably should cover up J-Wise too while you're at it.
I don't think that was very nice. You're gonna let him say that?